Hello and welcome to Advent with the Angels. This is day 15. My name's Liz and this is Guided by Angels. So every day on this series we're opening a door behind the Advent calendar and we're bringing in a message, and number 15 today is actually on this wreath here. So I feel that there's a message coming through today from the other side. So I'm going to bring in, as well as the Love and Light Oracle, the messages from the other side deck. This is one of my decks too. Bring in a message from a loved one that may be on your mind today. Maybe you're thinking about your mum or your dad or a sister, a brother, an uncle, an auntie or a friend who's passed over. And, you know, maybe you were thinking, I wish I could connect with them today. So I'm going to bring in a message. I feel someone may be visiting a grave today. You know, maybe you have kind of that annual visit to the grave where you put wreaths on there, you know, for Christmas, or, you know, maybe you pray or you talk to your loved one. And remember, we can do that wherever we are. We don't need to go to a grave or, you know, a monument to give love to our loved ones and connect with them, because they live on through us. They're in here. It's the memories in the heart. You know, it's the connection of the heart that never dies, no matter what. You know, love is beyond space, time and the material world. We're always connected. And remember, we're all psychic, which also gives us the gift to be able to connect with the other side. You just have to sometimes quiet your mind, be right in the right energy and breathe so that you know you're safe when you are connecting in that way. And if you want to connect with the other side, call on Archangel Azrael. Also call on Archangel Michael for protection so you feel safe when you're doing this, because of fear-based energies of TV and what people say. The angels have got you. You know, as long as you call on Michael and Azrael, you'll be okay when you're connecting with the other side. You'll feel safe. So I definitely feel there's a message coming through. So before I even open the door, let's bring that message in. You know, maybe this is the sign you've been waiting for today, to connect with a loved one over there. So thank you, angels. What do the loved ones on the other side want to say today? What are the messages from the other side? What are the messages? And this could be somebody that's passed recently or somebody that's been passed for a long time. But they have a message for you today. So sit with the energy, and, you know, even if you're not sure who this is communicating with you, it's just a beautiful message of love. You are never alone. So your loved one in heaven is saying to you, you are never alone. Even in those moments where we feel alone, we are surrounded by love. We are surrounded by our guardian angel, archangels, the ascended masters and loved ones in heaven. So you are never alone. So if you feel a little bit alone today, or maybe you're thinking about the approaching holidays and you're feeling alone, just breathe and know you are safe and surrounded with love. And I feel you could see a sign today that's unique to you and your journey with your loved one or whomever you're thinking about. If you, you know, if you don't see anything that's unique that way, you may see a wreath, because I feel you could see a wreath. Maybe you go to someone's house and there's a wreath on the door, or, and obviously I know that happens at Christmas time. But you're going to see something that's going to grab your attention, because it's a sign of a new beginning. And remember, endings are an opportunity for a new beginning. Even though it can be hard to lose a loved one, it's also another chapter or cycle in your own life. It's like a fresh start for you as well, you know, to grow. You know, every time we lose a loved one, we grow, we get stronger, we handle things differently because we see things in a new way. And you were never alone. You could see a feather, which is a symbol of protection, a coin, you know, anything that's kind of a message from loved ones. But I definitely feel you could see a wreath. I thought there would be more time. And that's the one thing, we can never get back time. So this is about understanding that time is also illusion. Time never runs out, because we have all the time we need. And God's in charge of that. You know, the only person who knows when we're going to go the other side is God. You know, God's in charge of that. So I feel this message is to enjoy every day. You know, if your loved one in heaven could give you a message, it would be enjoy each moment. Don't wish your life away or wish things were different. Enjoy the now, live. That's why you've come. And they thought there would be more time to maybe complete something or speak to you about something, or, you know, share love. Because when we are queuing up to come down here, we want to spend as much time down here as possible. Yet when we're alive, we forget that and we don't enjoy the moment. So the message is enjoy each moment. When you need me, I'm there. So this really is, along with you're never alone. So when you need help, when you need support, when you need to feel loved, your angels are there. And so is this loved one. When you need me, I'm there. You're not alone. You're not doing this on your own. Call on me for help. I will assist you. Because when we pass over, we can also become a spirit guide to our loved ones. So I feel your guides are around you saying, call on me and I will be there for you. Because when you need me, I am there. And you are an earthly angel. So you're being reminded that you've come to earth to help others, to be of service, to act as an angel on earth, which means to be very kind, loving, gentle, generous, giving, but also to give that to yourself, because the way we can be an angel to others is by being good to ourselves, by giving ourselves love and time and attention and energy, and then overflow with that so we can give that out to the world. So you have a mission here to help the world. Think of me fondly. I love that. You know, that's a real message about whenever you think of this person, no matter what's gone on, no matter what struggles have been around because of the ego in a physical body, that's all transitioned and healed. So think of them in a very fond way because that's how they think of you. You know, this is beautiful. You know, this is a song as well from Andrew Lloyd Webber's Phantom of the Opera. You know, think of me fondly. It's a really beautiful, powerful song. I am in a beautiful garden. I love that. You know, I love this card because my mum, when she was alive, loved the garden. She loved going in nature. She loved spending time in a garden, doing the gardening, or just sitting there and enjoying the sunshine. Or it was a real part of her transitioning. You know, she had cancer and she lived 7 years from having that cancer. And a garden was really her sanctuary because she didn't really go anywhere or do anything. So a garden was a retreat place. And I love to think of her in a beautiful garden. But this is also like the Garden of Eden, a beautiful garden. You know, so your person you were thinking about in heaven is in a very beautiful place right now. Like the garden, we think about the Garden of Heaven or the Garden of Gethsemane or, you know, the Garden of Eden, somewhere beautiful. So you can also connect with your loved ones in nature. Maybe in a garden, maybe you went to a park together or the certain place you went. You know, me and my mum, for example, went to a place called Trentham Gardens, which is near where we live. And it's beautiful. There's a big garden centre there, but there's also grounds. You know, it's a beautiful place. And there's like all outdoor shops as well. So I also connect with that. So I feel this is also maybe over the holidays, you may be going to places where you spend time with your loved ones in heaven. And you can connect with them there and you'll feel their presence around you because you're never alone. So maybe you haven't wanted to go there since they've passed over. Maybe it's been painful to do that. This may be a time to do that this year. So I'm in a beautiful garden. So I feel you're going to find them in places that you once went together. Isn't that beautiful? So let's go to the door number 15. And I also feel the wreath is a symbol of endings and new beginnings coming in with the end of 2023 and the new year ahead. So behind the door, we've got Santa and he looks like he's getting ready to go on his way. He's getting ready to go on his way. So I feel this is like saying goodbye to the past and saying hello to the future. So that's what I'm connecting with today. It's about being ready for new adventures, forgiving the past, letting go of the past. Especially if there's any pain around losing a loved one or if you're in separation from your twin flame or there's any pain around. It's like you're preparing for the new. So I feel this is kind of Santa saying, let's go on an adventure. Maybe you're traveling somewhere today or going somewhere. If you are, see it as a great adventure and understand that you are protected wherever you go. You know, Saint Christopher will assist you with navigation, with travel plans. So you can have the resources you need to go and do things, or you can have that thing you want. So let's bring in a message from the Love and Light Oracle. So I feel that this is a day where you could feel fresh and new and see today as a brand new adventure. So the card that's flying out the deck today is commit to a spirit of excellence. It says, whatever you do, do it well. I love this. Whatever you do, do it well. So put in 110% to whatever you're doing today. Even if that's just at going on an adventure or spending time with yourself, commit to a spirit of excellence. And when you wake up and think, today is going to be an excellent day. I'm going to excel today at everything I do. I'm going to put effort into things because it's good to do that. It makes me have purpose and value. I feel good today. I want to be motivated. I want to be excited about this day. I want to enjoy my life. Then you're going to excel at what you're doing. So commit to a spirit of excellence. And also, this could be about committing to spirit. In other words, committing to notice all the value around you today, being blessed, being in the moment, knowing you are loved, connecting with spirit in a very powerful way where you know they are there. So also going to places you used to go together, spending time where you used to spend time together. So commit to a spirit of excellence. And I feel that spirit are committed to helping you excel in your life, to help you with things you may be struggling with or dealing with or needing assistance with. You have spirit guides around you to help you. Loved ones in heaven, angels, guides, ascended masters. You know, whomever or whatever energy you're connecting with is there to help you today. And that's going to bring in peace. You know, you've got this gorgeous dove, which is a symbol of peace. And when you feel at peace, you thrive. You do things in a more excellent way because you feel good. And they're bringing me back to as well, you know, I mean, a film I used to love when I was growing up, Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure, which is a really great film anyway, you know, with Keanu Reeves in. But they go back in time to, you know, to excel in their history report, but they go along so many adventures, they grow, they learn, they evolve. And the real energy of that film is be excellent to each other. And that's what I'm feeling today. Be good to each other. It's like the message from the other side is be kind and gentle to yourself, but also to others, because we're all here to learn and grow. And we're all doing the best we can. And we're all brothers and sisters in the school of life. So when you start realizing that nobody is a stranger to you, because everyone is a friend to you. Everyone you meet, everyone who serves you in a coffee shop, everyone who you help, everyone who you smile at in the street, a stranger who assists you, these are your friends and family. So see it in a higher way today and life will be good. I hope this helps. Have a great day and I'll see you soon.